Today's lesson is on sentence pattern 4 and 4A, which I have dubbed the Beyonce and the Tumblr sentences. However, you're not going to see the Tumblr today just because I segmented it into two different lectures, but if you want me to go over it, I can, because I'm realizing this is a grammar learning thing for us all. So anyways, learning target. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to say the following with confidence. I can identify and write sentence patterns 4, which is the Beyonce, and 4A, which is the Tumblr. So when you're writing, you're not just putting words on paper, right? You're acting like a musician. You're giving a sentence a certain rhythm. So by incorporating different rhythms into your sentences, you can make your sentences sound better. So today we're going to talk about two rhythms, and the first rhythm that we're going to discuss is called staccato. Are there any musicians in this room that know what staccato means? On to it.
Staccato is short and sharp.
Yeah.
Like
so it's short, spiky, and detached, right? So, hold up your pencils. You're going to feel really stupid doing this, but this is staccato. Ready? This is not staccato. Da 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 da. Right? Because it's long, it's drawn out. We want short, spiky, detached. Just like tapping of your pencil. So, I wanted to find a video example to let you hear what staccato sounds like. And my good friend Beyonce was not wearing enough clothing in this video. for me to show you her video.
Nope.
Didn't pay.
She found it.
It did not. Let's go here. Why is it making that sound? Can I just okay. Yeah, I should have.
Maybe just right click the face.
So go to the make the presentation happen. That works.
Oh, that didn't do a damn. Okay, that's good.
Or maybe just write the head case.
Ah!
Oh.
Okay. I don't know why. So instead, I give you Joe Jonas, who will be dancing to Single Ladies. And I want you to listen, especially for the O-O-O, because that is staccato. So listen to this, okay? When you go to the parts, you're not listening to all of Beyonce before we get here. Okay, here we go. Staccato. If you need to pull up your pencil and tap, totally cool with it. Could I put a conjunction in there? Where could I put a conjunction? after keys. After keys. So listen to it without the conjunction. This morning, I lost my wallet, my keys, my mind. Right? So if we include and, listen to it again. This morning, I lost my wallet, my keys, and my mind. It loses the staccato sound. Right? Okay. Oh, so what does the staccato do to the sentence? What does it make you feel? Let's talk about our feelings.
The rhythm.
What's that?
Rhythm.
Yeah, is it rhythm? Does it
balance?
Do you notice anything more about the sentence? Yes.
You kind of can relate to losing your keys, your wallet, and then your mind.
Yeah, there's an emphasis, right? And it's sort of a buildup, isn't it? So it's hard to notice in one sentence, but I pulled a sentence from our reading last night in The Giver, and this is from page 70. Once, when he had been a four, he had said, just prior to the midday meal at school, I'm starving. Immediately, he had been taken aside for a brief private lesson in language precision. He was not starving, it was pointed out. He was hungry. No one in the community was starving, never been starving, but ever be starving. To say starving was to speak a lie. So I want you to turn to the person next to you and tell them what this staccato sound does to this paragraph.
So it makes it more impactful.
Serious.
Yeah. It makes it more impactful. You do it.
Okay.
It makes it more impactful. No one was starving, but I've been starving, whatever been starving, right? It's just a very, like you see them, like, fisting it every time. No one was starving, but I've been starving, right? Sounds a little more angry, but it's like,
hey,
pickles, pork rinds.
I like tacos.
At our Super Bowl party with pickles, tacos,
and
course.
Okay. Do we need to label them?
Can we make these plural if you need to?
Yeah.
Okay.
You can even come up with your own. Come on, some verbs.
After the Seahawks lost, I threw my pork rinds, tacos, and pickles.
At the TV.
And pickles?
No.